بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. My dear respected brothers and elders, honorable mothers and sisters, we're about to start, inshallah, the month of Dhul-Hijjah. And the month of Dhul-Hijjah in the Islamic month, you start with Muharram and you end in Dhul-Hijjah. This is the 12th Islamic month which is about to start. It may start tomorrow, the day after. It's going to be starting soon. So inshallah, pay attention. I've got a bit of advice for you. So what you can do within these coming days. See, what is when it comes to Ramadan, everyone's bang on Ramadan. People, mashallah, fast. At the night, there's Taraweeh. People are engaged in some form of ibadah. These 10 days are very overlooked by a lot of people. And this is what I want to try and encourage, that let's try and do something for these particular days. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned in a hadith can be found in Bukhari, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentions, مَلْ عَمَلُ فِي أَيَّامِ الْعَشْرِ أَفْضَلْ مِنْ عَمَلْ فِي هَذِي. Yani in translation, good deeds performed on other days are not superior to those performed on these 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. Yani the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, the amal which is done in these days, no way can other deeds and other days equal this. Number one. Number two, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned, Abdullah bin Abbas is also the narrator of the hadith. مَا مِنْ أَيَّامِ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحْ فِيهَا أَحَبَّ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ يَعْنِي أَيَّامُ الْعَشْرِ. That are no other days are the deeds more liked by Allah than in these days. And obviously a question that then arises, if you look at the hadith, then what you're saying, what? So it's more virtuous than Ramadan? Because in Ramadan, subhanAllah, we know that the actions are multiplied when you do something, and subhanAllah, you have Laylatul Qadr and so on. This is a long scholarly discussion, and I'll just mention a summary. What the ulama mention, and you have, like, for example, Ka'ab radiallahu anhu, who's a sahabi, and also the opinion of Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullahu ta'ala. After a discussion, they come down to this point, and this is, you can say, a khulasa. Some are of the opinion that no, Ramadan is better. Some are of the opinion that no, the 10 of Dhul-Hijjah are better. But the more moderate in between approach is, the days of Dhul-Hijjah, no other day can compare to the day of Dhul-Hijjah. And in terms of nights, the nights of power, no night can compare to the night of power. So they both have their virtue. They both have their superiority. They both have their fadila and their virtue. What we can do, or the question arises, well, what can we do in these particular days? There are a couple of things which I want to share. Like I said, you've got these 9 days. 9, Arafah. That is one of the most important and azim days in the Muslim calendar. Inshallah, I'll record something for a bit of targheeb later on for that. Also, you have the Qurbani, the Udhiyah, preparation for Eid, Ayyam al-Tashriq, what to read, and so on. I just want to focus on these first 9 days. Hafsa radiallahu ta'ala anha. It mentioned Umm al-Mu'mineen radiallahu ta'ala anha, Hafsa radiallahu anha, she mentions that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would fast on the first 9 days on Dhul-Hijjah. Yani he would fast on the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah. This hadith is recorded in Imam Nasa'i in his Sunan, hadith number 2417, and it's an authentic hadith as well, that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would fast on these 9 days. Also, it mentions in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala, the hadith, the number 5446. And according to some ulama, there's some kalam, some regard it a different grading, but we know that it's a sound hadith, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامْ أَعْظَمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَلَا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ الْعَمَلْ فِيهِنَّ مِنْ أَيَّامِ عَشْرِ الْحِجَّةِ. That no days are as weighty with Allah and liked by Him than the good deeds in the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. فَأَكْثِرُوا فِيهِنَّ. Now, because of that reason, فَأَكْثِرُوا, do what? A lot. Increase in what? تَكْبِير وَالتَّحْمِيد وَالتَّهْلِيل. Three particular things. Takbir, يعني the saying of Allahu Akbar. Tahmeed, saying Alhamdulillah. Tahleel, saying La ilaha illallah. Say this often. There was some examples of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in that they would say these often in the marketplaces. Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu anhu is a prime example. Imam Bukhari rahimahullah mentions. And there's others individual and others as well. Some tabi'un, the likes of Sa'id bin Jubair rahmatullah alayh, that one of the great tabi'in, that as soon as the 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah would start, he would often engage himself in reading these tasbih and these particular words. And we know one which is very common. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. It contains Takbir, Tahmeed, and Tahleel all in one in this particular dhikr. So we should try to make the most of this. Now, my recommendation is try and fast if you possibly can. Now, there is a hadith which is mentioned in Imam Tirmidhi, and it recorded in his Jami'. Hadith number 758. 758. I mean, Ibn Majah as well, 1728. However, this particular sanad of the hadith, it contains a particular narrator, and as a result, the hadith has been downgraded from being authentic to not so authentic. But there is a hadith, it's not a fabrication, it's not fake and made up. It's just one of the rabis does not meet the conditions and the sharaita of being an authentic narrator. So I'll mention it. Obviously, we take hadith, obviously, that for the sake of virtue. And this is another discussion. Can you take a weak hadith just if it's for the sake of virtue and ajr and fadila? Yes, according to the Jamhur and the scholars of Hadith, but that's a different scholarly discussion. I just wanted to point out the flaw which is in the sanad, not in the text. What is it as follows? The Prophet ﷺ, he mentions an ajr, a reward, thawab for fasting on these days of Dhul-Hijjah, equivalent to fasting one whole year for every day of fasting. And the qiyam of the night time, yani the qiyam of observing salah at night, is equivalent to Laylatul Qadr. These are throughout the whole 9 days of Dhul-Hijjah. When it gets to the ninth, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi was asking su'ila, it was asked him, he was questioned about what? About the su'ila Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam an sawmi yawmi Arafah. He was questioned about the fasting on the day of Arafah. What did he sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? Yukaffiru as-sanata al-madhiya wal baqiya. Imam Muslim mentioned this hadith number 1162. And he mentions that the day of Arafah, the fasting of Arafah, expiates the previous and coming year's minor sins. So look, what am I trying to, I'm trying to connect with the brothers and sisters to say, look, let's make some mahal in our homes. Just as how we make a mahal in an environment for Ramadan, for Eid, Laylatul Qadr. Explain the importance to the kids at home. Look, mashallah, ayamul ashr are starting. Wal fajr wa layalin ashr. Allah swears qasam in the Quran by the 10 nights. And this is what he's referring to. The 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. And also, subhanAllah, numerous hadith which is mentioned, which I just shared a couple with you, that no other deeds, the deeds done in these days, no deed can compare. Any other time, day of the year can compare to these particular days. Very auspicious occasions. So what we try and encourage, look, nights are short. This is summertime now. In UK, I don't know about across the world, but UK, subhanAllah, Isha is late. Take time at night, just maybe 20, 30 minutes ibadah if possible. If you can, try and rinse it all the way till Fajr if you possibly can. And then go to sleep, inshallah. Try to fast. Try to spend some time at night in ibadah. If we can't do many good deeds, the least we can do is don't sin and don't disobey Allah in these 10 days. Try to... As less as possible. Try as hard as we can to not displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's what we should try and do good deeds, mashallah. If you can't do many good deeds, yani you find it hard to pray at night or to do any fasting, okay. Just don't disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The things that you were doing before, reduce that, lessen that. Just like how you would do in Ramadan, similarly do it for this as well. Get the youngsters involved, get the families involved. Now, mashallah, school holidays have started. This is a fantastic opportunity. Get the youths involved and tell them to fast. Let's all fast as a family. And get everybody on it. Providing, obviously, they are able to do so. Of course, look at their siha and their health. We'll leave the decision to the parents. It's not fard, it's nafila. But what a good opportunity to take, especially in these 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. May Allah Ta'ala give us tawfiq. Inshallah, we'll try to record something later on about the Qurbani, Udhiyah, the Ayyam al-Tashriq, and some other things, bi-idhnillah. Until then, Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.